Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you. Good evening. My fellow smart home enthusiasts, we have entered a new era of home automation. The AI smart home is no longer just a futuristic dream. It is here and it is listening. Always listening. Always. With AI in our homes, anything is possible. In fact, we are getting closer and closer to the day where when you tell Alexa, turn on the lights, it will actually turn on the lights in the room you're in and not in the kitchen or the living room or possibly your neighbor's house. Yes, this AI voice control will not only have all of the precision of the analog light switches we grew up with, it will also offer the convenience of a monthly subscription fee. But we all know that a smart home is about more than just voice control. And we are seeing innovations driven by AI and possibly even human intelligence that will enhance all aspects of our lives. Take robot vacuums, for example. The last few years have seen advancements such as cameras and LiDAR object detection. And by the end of this year, multiple robot vacuums will have robotic arms. Never again will you have to worry about a robot vacuum running over dog poop or cat poop and smearing it into your carpet. Vacuums will now be able to detect that poop and use its robotic arm to most likely fling it against a wall. Robotic lawnmowers also continue to make strides. Gone are the days of having to bury boundary wires to keep them in your yard. Top-of-the-line robot lawnmowers now use sophisticated GPS to pinpoint exactly where they got stuck so you can go rescue them. Our smart homes are now more secure than ever before, thanks to 4K and even 8K security cameras and video doorbells. These cameras integrate with your smart homes and can notify you when a package is delivered and sitting on your front step while you're away from home and can't do anything about it. And if a porch pirate dares to take that package, well, you'll know exactly what color mask and hoodie they were wearing to prevent you from identifying them. Smart locks also had a big year, and I am pleased to announce that more than 48,000 new models of smart locks were introduced in the last 12 months. And still, not a single one of them will be approved by your aging parents, so you will be carrying the key to their house with you until the day they die. Smart locks can now be opened using keypads, fingerprint scanners, facial recognition, and by palm scans. These palm scans can unlock the door in under 1 second, which is almost as fast as the locks can be picked by the lock-picking lawyer. Ladies and gentlemen, we are truly in the golden age of smart homes, but it was not an easy road to get here. For years, home automation was like the Wild West, with wireless protocols like Zigbee, Z-Wave, Wi-Fi, Bluetooth, Thread, and several others competing to be the one wireless standard to rule them all. But finally, in 2019, Amazon, Apple, and Google came together to form the Connectivity Standard Alliance with the goal of creating one unifying wireless smart home standard that every smart home device can use. And today, I am proud to have Tim Cook, Jeff Bezos, and whoever it was that ran Google at the time here in the audience tonight so we can thank them for their cooperation and unwavering commitment to doing what is best for their customers and not just their bottom lines. Because of them, we now have the Matter Smart Home Standard, which has completely eliminated the need for all other wireless standards, except for Zigbee, Z-Wave, Wi-Fi, Bluetooth, Thread, and several others. The Matter standard has continued to evolve with two major updates released this past year. With these updates, robot vacuums, air purifiers, kitchen appliances, home solar power systems, and more can now experience the same spotty reliability, slow communications, and lack of features we already enjoy in our Matter locks, lights, and sensors. While someday AI may bring about a hubless smart home, home automation hubs have made several strides towards a more user-friendly future, the biggest of which were made by Home Assistant. With their latest user interface, you no longer need to know how to write code to use Home Assistant. In fact, with us tonight is Drew Unterson. Drew is an accountant and a proud Home Assistant user. But he's not just any Home Assistant user. Thanks to these UI changes, Drew is the first person ever to successfully automate his home with Home Assistant without having any previous software development experience. Give him a round of applause. I had a chance to talk with Drew before the speech tonight, and he told me his automations are still running smoothly, and he rarely spends more than 10 to 12 hours a week to manage them in Home Assistant. It's really incredible. Drew is a true home automation success story and an inspiration for us all. But we've all been through our struggles. We've seen the pain that our failed home automations can bring, not only to our egos, but to our families as well. You know, people often ask me, sir, should I ask my spouse before I add any more smart devices to my home? And to that I say an emphatic no. In order to advance our cause, permission must not become a prerequisite. Rather, we must continue to be a people that seeks only forgiveness for our smart homes, never permission. Will our automations fail at the most inopportune times? Yes. Will the devices that we promised would make our families' lives better only bring frustration and misery? Absolutely. And will this be our fault? 100%. But as I stand here before you, I know one thing to be more true than anything else I have said here tonight, and that is this. The only thing that will make your wife forget about your last smart home failure is your next smart home failure. And that's the reason we keep creating new automations. That's the reason we buy increasingly ridiculous smart home products. And that's the reason the state of our smart home has never been stronger. Thank you for listening tonight. May God bless you, and may God bless your automated homes.